About 1985, I wrote a song about Bridport. When I first arrived back in West Dorset in 86, you could still find so many family firms in Bridport, and one by one, with the supermarkets opening on the edge of town, you could see them close down. And I was as guilty as anyone else where I chose to spend my dollar. So I really thought it's going to be charity shops and closed down shops, but spent 2 days in Bridport over Christmas. You can now get about 18 cappuccinos, and the town looks like it's buzzing. It's really, really brilliant to wake up this morning in the Bull Hotel and see a lively, vibrant place. So this song was written about English small country towns, but I think we may be able to exempt Bridport from this. All right, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2.
Cold winds are blowing down the high street today. Just look around you. Family firms selling up and moving away. Now the names that surround you, though they're familiar, you don't feel at home. You could be in Kansas, London or Rome. All closing down in this small country town, in the cold heart of England. to send you from there. The cold heart of England. So it's grey supermarkets instead of green fields to pay all our wages. Are we choking in traffic and tied to the wheel like cattle in cages? And if you work to the limits the law will allow, you'll find the land under concrete instead. We need you right now in the cold heart of England. The cold heart of England.
Thank you. We've toured with some wonderful American songwriters over the last few years. And when they talk about Milwaukee and Illinois crossing the state line, all we've got is Yeovil. Richard Schindel wrote this song. Driving through the East Midlands, he goes, "Hey, Loogahoa, Borogahoga." Our place names. This is a road song written by Richard Schindel.
It's the middle of the night on the Indiana line. I'm pulling down the Christian station. Signal's crystal clear. I cannot hear what he says about Revelation. I am wretched, I am tired. He's on fire. Wish I could believe him. Whoever watches over all these truckers, spare a little mercy for a weary sinner. And the Lord deliver me. Tremble in the hands that reaches out to take my quarter. I look him in the eye, but there isn't any time, just time to pass tender. Oh, I may take this toll, the green light flashes go. Nothing for these stars to shine through. brings me back to you. Something missing. I am wretched, I am tired. Oh, the preacher, he's on fire. Wish I could believe it. Whoever watches over all these troubles, Seven Beach,
Bull Hotel in Brentford.
Whoa, yes.
Where we drank all the port wine.
We drank all the port wine. And then there's the Travelodge forgot. On the A303 at Barton Stacey. And then, of course, Express at Swindon, where we may never go again. Whoops.
Mrs. Bromley's guest house in Burton Bradstone.
Oh, yes.
Breakfast is between 8 and 8.15. Then you're out. Well, some of you are staying there. Sorry about that.
In fact, Mrs. Grumbly is probably here. And then, the Angel at Alton, where the bar stays open all night. And then finally, the Dorchester Fat Chance.
Awesome.
When Richard first sang us that song, I said, that really does remind me of my favourite song, which is Lowell George's Willing. And he said, funny you should say that, Lowell George's Willing is also my favourite song. That's why I wrote that song. Just thought you ought to know.
Way back in the early days when we used to play in the pubs in the area, we used to like to take a well-known song and folk it up a bit. Give it the show of hands treatment. This is a classic piece. Well, we're on our Americana theme. We're going to return to England after this set. This is a classic piece of American adult rock and roll music. Originally located in Los Angeles, we've moved this to West Bay, an infinitely more exotic and romantic location, apart from the pebbles. You might remember this. There's a lovely sun going down, early summer's evening sun. Nobody on the road, nobody on the beach. I feel it in the air, the summer's out of reach. Empty lake, empty street, the sun goes down alone. I'm driving by your house, oh I know you're not home, and I can see you. Brown skin shining in the sun. You got the top pulled down and radio on, baby. I can tell you my love for you will still be strong after the boys' summer. Never will forget those nights. Wonder if it was a dream. Remember how you made me crazy. Remember how I made you scream. I don't understand what happened to our love. But I'm gonna get you back. Gonna show you what I'm made of. Now I can see you. Brown skin shining in the sun. I see you walking real slow and smiling at everyone. Now I can tell you my love for you will still be strong after the boys of summer. Out on the road today, I saw a deadhead sticker on a Cadillac. Little voice inside my head said, don't look back, you can never look back. Thought I knew what love was, what did I know? Those days are gone forever, I should just let them go. But I can see you. Brown skin shining in the sun. You got the top boat down in the radio on, baby. I can tell you my love for you will still be strong after the boys of summer gone. I can see you. Got your hair swept back and those wayfarers on, baby. Now I can tell you my love for you will still be strong after the boys of summer have gone. So we've been playing a song called The Keeper for a long, long time, for 20 years maybe, about a Devonshire man at the Battle of the Somme. And I found out in 2014, in the course of touring around, actually play after playing at Dorchester Arts Centre, that my grandfather, who was in the Dorset Regiment, actually re-enlisted in the Devonshires. This was completely news to our family. He re-enlisted at the age of 41 in 1914 and was at the Battle of the Somme. And so, Phil and I have recently been involved in a project with Six Rifles at Wyvern Barracks. The CO is opening up the barracks for a big concert, the last three nights, in fact. And I wrote a song specially, and we were there with the Salamanca band and the band of the Rifles, and it has been a wonderful, very military, very well-organized occasion. But on the press launch, we had a working breakfast in the officer's mess about 2 months ago. Huge table on the wall in the officer's mess. All of the regimental colours, the Gloucesters, the Devonshires, the Dorset, Devon and Dorsets, and the Rifles. And there's a picture on the wall of the Devonshires at the Battle of the Trench at the Somme. It says, the Devonshires held this trench, and they held it still. And I came into the room, and every seat at this officer's mess was taken by a journalist, someone from a local council, one of the officers, the adjutant. There was about 24 people. There was an empty chair at the top. And I didn't, normally I'm quite good at sitting at the top of the chair at people's houses, but I was a bit reluctant because I didn't know if it had been left empty for a reason. And there was a journalist there, a lady. I said, "Do you like to sit there?" And she said, "No." So I sat in the chair. And the commanding officer said, "Do you know there's a story behind that chair, Steve? It was carved from a tree that was cut down at the trench that the Devonshires held. And it was made by the commanding officer. And you're sitting in a chair that was carved by someone who was at that action." And when I looked at the picture next to it, I realized that when my grandfather re-enlisted, he was with the 8th Devonshires who were at that engagement in the trench. So it was strange, all these stories connecting. And then last night, at the end of the show, rather unexpectedly, the CO and the adjutant walked on stage, which completely threw me, and he said, "As a commanding officer, I have certain rights, certain things I can do. So will you kindly step forward, Steve? I'd like to name you Honorary Rifleman of 6 Rifles." And he gave me a beret with the bugle on it, which was identical to the one that my stepbrother wore in the Royal Green Jackets. And he asked me to put it on, which I did, and then he saluted, and I saluted back. And it was strange that all these stories, the keeper playing at Dorchester, my grandfather, that table, and that moment, all connected. So we're going to invite Chris Hoban to join us to sing this song, which is the original song, The Keeper, that started this whole story off. So woven with a couple of folk songs as well. That's a bit savage. This is The Keeper. I dedicate this to Mike out there, former rifleman. In Devonshire, I was a keeper, and half my life I lived outdoors. Using scales, my father taught me, on the land that edged the open moors. I'd cut the snares of every poacher, rising hours before the sun. I set traps and I planted cover as we drove the birds towards the gun. Master, very well done. Oh, down, very, very down. Oh, deep so deep. Hey, down, down. Down, down, down. Oh, down. Half the county, with all the skill that I brought from home. I set traps, we laid the wire, till the earth grew red as Devon's home. July the 1st, 1916, we early rode past around, whistles blew, and we broke cover, rolling right down to Margaret is a dream. Oh, love is back on the land, I hire the beaten. When the glorious 12th has come,
We stand in line, we wait in silence.
The lily for the dead.
by Lily and the Rose, written by this man. The best unknown songwriter, this is Mr. Chris Hogan from Tottenham. Still not getting paid, it's not all. Had he not been here, I could have claimed authorship for that. This is a... This song was quite transforming in a way. Before we were playing with Miranda a lot, Phil and I would regard it as a couple of folky blokies from the West Country. We were doing okay, we were ticking over. But this song rather changed the perception. It didn't get us playlisted, but it got us on Farming Today. Country life. Try this. Once more. All the way to the back. Let's hear it. A bit louder. Country love. Working in the rain, cutting up wood. Didn't do my little brother much good. Lost two fingers in a chainsaw bite. All he does now is drink and fight. Sells a bit of grass on some cars. Talks of travel, never gets smart. Loves his kids, left his wife. An everyday story of country life. And the red brick cottage where I was born is the empty shell of a holiday home. Most of the year there's no one there. The village is dead and they don't care. Now we live on the edge of town. Haven't been back since the pub closed down. One man's family pays a price for another man's vision of country life. Come on, I'm singing. Three county stops. Where were you when they lost their jobs? No one marched or subsidized to save a country away from the line. Sure, cattle burning in funeral fire. Out to Greece they look so sweet. We hate the blood, but we crave the meat. Buy me a beer or take my knife. Cut you a slice of country life. Family farms that are brought to heel by a hammer blow of size and scale. Foot and mouth, just another nail in the coffin of this English dream. It lies out there in the village green, where ragged barons come and agricultural policy in hand strip our pleasant land of meadow, woodland, hedgerow, farm. What remains they build upon? No trains, no shops, no pubs. Something's wrong. A real local song for you. It's called The Blue Cockade. Oh, yeah. And this is the version collected in Bemister in 1906 from the singing of a Mr. Ralph Bugler. And when I was teaching part-time in Bemister School, I did something about this song to a class, and everybody turned around and stared at one of the kids in the class. It was a young bugler. He was the great-great-great-grandson of this chap. We have no idea that anyone his family had ever sung a folk song and was rather embarrassed. So we sang this for the first time, the Red Line. But now with Miranda singing with us, we can bring it to life a bit more because it is a conversation between a man and a woman. He's about to, well, he gets drunk and joins up for a year and a half. And he says to her, darling, the good news is that when I come back, we will get married. He asks for his credit cards and bank account details. In various versions of the country, she's very forgiving, but this is a Dorset vision. Slightly more realistic. It was on Monday's morning, as I crossed o'er the moss, I little thought of listening till the soldiers did me cross. The company enticed me to drink their health all around, and the bounty, and the bounty they gave me, 5 guineas and a crown. My head was full of drink, love, I didn't think of you. And now I'm forced to go and join the orange and the blues. Our ship, it waits at anchor to take a flowing tide. I'll return. Thank you. Once a month, Phil and I, on a Tuesday, we get together with some old friends from the Dearly Folk Club days, where we first met, in Exmouth, and we have a lunch and we talk about old times and we have a few drinks. I didn't realise I can now claim this as a business production meeting, which is brilliant. And in the course of these conversations, we talk about some of the songs we've never played together, but we heard when we were younger. And this one, we both lived in Brighton at various times. We've just lost a very close friend, Stuart Reed of the Brighton Taverners, and we'll dedicate this to Stuart, because it would have been in those days when Stuart's place in above Matthew's the Butcher's was the place to hang out when we were hanging out. And there was a fine Irish songwriter called Adrian Mannering. Bit of a character, actually, Adrian. He wrote a lovely song called My True Love, and we recorded this and played it on our last duo tour we've just finished. I don't know what happened to Adrian. Phil tells me he's now a barrister in Dublin. I don't make any sense of that. I think he's a barista. I think he makes coffee. I cannot relate the guy that I knew to someone in a wig with briefs. Is that right?
The Wig and Briefs, yes, that famous pub in Hove. That's worrying, the number of people who laughed when I said that. Anyway,
the bulldog it was.
No, I can add the bulldog, yeah, absolutely. I can assure everyone that Adrian is alive. He's probably a judge now. The last time I saw him was 10 years ago. And he invited me and the people I was with down to Dublin Law Courts. Living evidence, once again, that our Irish cousins get it so right sometimes. Because he took us up the steps through the hallowed portals of the Law Courts and said, would you be having a drink, Phil?
Wait again, sir.
I'm looking around and says, I said, oh, all right, and thinking we were going to go to his office, you know, and have a sneaky whiskey or something like that. So he led us into the law library, and there are all these people in their wigs and briefs, doing their homework, working up cases, their piles of books, and all the rest of it. Every single one of them's got a pint. Because off the law library, there is a bar. Chorus. And Came here 20 years ago. The stage was a sort of greenhouse area over in the corner there. The audience stopped at that tree, so we had maybe 200 or 300, and it's grown every year. And we're very proud with what we've achieved. Mr. Peter Wilson there, integrally involved in those early days, and our agent all those years ago. Please give Peter a round of applause. He seems to be leaving. Thank you. This is a song that we first started playing in 1998. We went to India for a tour. In those days, you couldn't take any rupees out of the country, but you could get paid in room service. And Lee Enfield, well, what is it? Not a rifle.
Not Lee Enfield, no, I had
the motorbike we used.
I just wanted to point out that I had strict words with the CNC. It was all very well making an honorary rifleman, but under no circumstances is he to give you a rifle.
We were making a journey late one night to Hyderabad.
Royal Enfield.
Royal Enfield, not Leland. Yeah. Making a journey to Hyderabad, which is a Muslim city. And in our carriage, there was an elderly gentleman who must have been in his mid-80s. 1988, they were celebrating and remembering 50 years of independence. But they're also remembering some of the tragic journeys that happened at the time of partition, some of the families that were separated. He was returning home to Hyderabad for the first time in 50 years. And we chatted to this lovely old chap. And he said, I don't know if there's anybody to meet me. I know my brother's going to be there, but I don't know what family I have. And when we got to the station early in the morning, we thought we ought to follow him to see how this story unfolded. And all along the platform, there was about 75 people of all ages to greet this chap. So to see him reunited was very inspiring, and it started this piece of music, which we originally recorded in this palace called the Umaidwan Palace. All these corridors converge in this wonderful dome, and to play a note, it resonates for literally minutes, and
So we're trying to recreate that moment, and we're going to run into an Irish folk song. This is the train. This land's divided forever changed. Your path lies east and mine remains. Go by darkness. Oh,
seven to ten. Port to Vale, peak to Fen. Played in cafe and Loughborough bar. Stood in the streets with my first guitar. But I'd be richer than all the rest. I wish I had a pound for each request. The tune in banjo's American Pie. It's enough to make you cry. Rule Britannia, swing my love. The only song is the English name. See the flower fruit. We're never gonna grow without their roots. Watch and stand and shoot.
What do we need? We need roots, hey!
Cake's been cut, disco's over, bar is shut. Birthday, christening, wedding or wake. What can we sing till the morning breaks? For the Indian, Asian and Afro-Celt. It's in the blood below the belt. Singing and dancing all night long. What have they got right? We've got wrong. See the flower fruit. Never gonna grow without their roots. Branch, stem and shoot.
Far away, boys, let them go. Out in the wind and the rain and snow. We've lost more than we'll ever know.
Round the
rocky shores of England.
Try that.
All away, boys, let them go. Out in the wind and the rain and snow. We've lost more than we'll ever know.
Round the rocky shores of England. Said his vision would help. His three folk singers at a pub near Wells. I got a vision of urban sprawl and pubs when no one ever sings at all. And everyone stares at great big screens. Open late soccer star prancing team. Australian salute. America's coming on.
And displacement and people travelling and moving around the world. This is yet another. Phil's going to sing this one, and it's one I wrote a while ago when I still lived in London. And where did you hear? Phil first heard this in Wimborne, town of bright lights and romance.
Wimborne. I sometimes dream of Wimborne. The kind of town that looks great in your rearview mirror.
Oh, don't be uncalled. No, that was really uncalled for.
It was uncalled for.
Bloke came up to us in a car park in Wimborne. He said, "Here, mate, don't ever play in Blandford, whatever you do." I said, "Why?" He said, "Full of people like me." He had a point.
It was the Wimborne Folk Festival 1986. I was there with the... I was still in the Albion Band at the time.
I was there doing a reunion gig with the Arizona Smoke Review, Steve rolled up with an acoustic guitar and a sheaf of new songs, one of which was exceptional. One out of the sheaf. it was a really good song, Steve. It still is a really good song.
A sheaf? How many songs in the sheaf do you reckon? I'd say 30 or 40 would be bad.
A lot of songs, but this one stood out. And that's when this is 1986, when we sat down, had a beer afterwards, and just discussed the possibility of doing some acoustic
Let's be
stuff.
Folk gods, Phil.
Yeah, folk gods. Yes.
You can end up wearing a kurta, and I'll end up wearing a rifleman's beret.
Rifleman's beret, just don't give him the gun. And
you've really put an idea in my head.
No. So,
Thunder the flashes. I can get them.
I've got some. This was the song, and like a lot of the songs that Steve's written over the years, as he just said, this one kind of, the content and the what's being expressed in this song seems to refresh itself with monotonous and depressing, sort of, just keeps on coming round again and again and again, basically. This is Exile.
Well, the shadow passed over me. Will it stay forevermore? Like wave I'm breaking far at sea. There's no one to hear the roar. All the days are drifting into seasons. They're the longest I have known. Million spaces in the earth to fill, but no going home. There's no going home. I could dream before the break of day that I'm back with you again. Then the morning blows its all away, leaves an echo of your name. Still a thousand miles of light between us, we're waking up alone. What if I could cross 100 borders? There's no going. There's no going. When it thunders from the empty sky, I should be there. No one to hold you when storm birds fly. There's no one left to care. Search the rumors with my hollow plans. When all I want is what's mine. Lost and lonely in a foreign land. Left so far behind the line. I want to tear down the walls between us. I can do it on my own.
open spaces in the earth to fill. And there's a generation waiting still. They got year after year to kill.
Happy birthday to Dave Hunt out there.
Happy birthday, Francesca, out there.
Jan Lepage, happy birthday. From Sandra and Dawn. Little Rosie, young Rose Wildman, who's 8. We have Jenny over there, sir, but we're somebody, we are some people's birthday present. Obviously, they couldn't think of anything to give them. Miles and Mike as well, hello to you. Oh, got some more. Your nephew. Chris's nephew, Alfie Reed, is 10 today. Is he over there? Did he pay to get in? Did he buy an album?
And last but not least, Debbie Moore. 39 again today, Debbie Moore.
Yeah. You're supposed to say the age, are you, Phil?
That's what it says here, okay. Steve.
You've got to be careful with that sort of thing.
She won't hear this as she's been on the G&T. We're doing.
This one. Our song about corporate greed that we thought would have a shelf life of 6 months. William Hague's favourite song.
Don't be vague, ask for Hague.
We played this on the Andrew Marr show about 7 or 8 years ago. I met his special advisor after the show. Very well spoken, Oxbridge Titan. Can I do my joke? I said, can I send the Foreign Secretary one of our CDs? What did he say, Miranda?
No, you can't, but his pronunciation was rubbish.
Are you fed up with that joke? Miranda did a joke! Yeah! Didn't quite deliver it with full conviction. They've never heard that before, have you? 1, 2, 3, 4! Sold, poisoned, every water and home, your probity, you betrayed for
thank you.
No feather bed or golden egg, and no one pays him to work. Now where's your thrift and your caution and your honest sound advice? You doubt yourself when you hide, and you load it every time.
At every trough you stop to feed.
Come on now.
Guys, all the crew, Marcus and Josh and Naomi and Jamie, Ninian. Will you please give all our crew a round of applause for amazing. Please welcome back to the stage, Chris Hogan. Let's hear it for Kirsty Merrin, who played earlier. Let's hear it for Alden Dashwood and Patson. Give them a round of applause. Wonderful Midnight Sky Racer. And then blokes. Please don't hold them.
From the ports of the west, we sailed into the sun. South America bound, our journey begun.
Planes on the way.
to the sun. South America bound, and our journey is done. There'll be laughter and song in the barrio, and it will echo half a world away. When the real one is a your voices. We do not have a gig on Wednesday night, which is semi-final night.
Do you know what? I do.
So do I. Football's not coming home for you today. No. Where's your gig, Phil? Where's your gig?
Telling you. Oh. You might come.
Thank you so much. You know, we never had like the hit, as you know. We've released singles. They haven't really troubled the scorers, so to speak. But the one song, I suppose, whenever we sing it, gets the best reaction is this one, Cousin Jack. Surprisingly, because it was so specific to Cornwall and the Cornish and the Cornish diaspora. But in a way, I suppose it's about anybody trying to find a better life for their families. And That basic need in us to try and find sanctuary and safe haven, which seems to be unstoppable. So we'll leave this one with you. It'd be lovely to hear your voices. Thank you so much again. Put this whole thing together. Vicky and Amanda, and also Martin here at Abbotsbury. Done an amazing job. A lot of organisation goes into this. Backstage, we've already thanked the crew for feeding us and looking after us, as they have done for years. But please give Vicky and Amanda from Firebrand a round of applause. Thanks again.
it anymore.
Let's open on the talking back.